This European-style nymphing technique has been a really popular technique as of recent, simply because it's an extremely effective way to nymph. And the reason why it's really effective is that it uses heavier flies and light tippet. And what that does is allows us to penetrate the water column much faster, get our flies into the strike zone, and give ourselves more opportunity. So when you look at a run, kind of similar to what we're fishing here, you know, I got a quick glance, it's relatively uniform. There's not a lot of really defined, you know, breaks, rocks, logs, main current seam. It's kind of a uniform flow, which can be kind of intimidating on how you might approach it. So what we try to do is break it down into grid, and we might take our casting distance, maybe 15, 20 feet out in front of us, and kind of pick that as our lane, and kind of just work our way out into the river fishing that lane. And with this technique, again, we can be relatively precise with where we're casting and where our flies are, based on the fact we can use our sighter to tell us how the flies are coming down the river and where they are. So by doing that, we can start to kind of closer evaluate the water, look for small bubble lines, little surfaces disturbances, as well as these microcurrents that are kind of little surface indicators that there could be something going on underneath, or that's the main flow where the food is kind of coming down. So we may kind of choose a little lane, a little bubble line, and we're going to work that, put a few drifts through it. Once we feel like we've covered that bubble line well enough, or that 6 inches or that 12 inches really well, we're just going to take maybe lengthen our line just a little bit more, kind of pick that next little lane that looks pretty good and start running cast down that. And then you're going to simply run a certain amount of drifts through there, 4, 5, 6, whatever, and then simply wait out a little bit further and try to keep that lane kind of coming straight across the river. And once you get to a point where either you can't wait enough or you don't want to disturb that far water, maybe you'll come back and fish it from the other bank. You'll come back, slide upstream another 20 feet or so, 25 feet, so you're kind of creating a new section, and then fish that exactly like we were talking about, just going right down that lane, picking all those little micro seams and kind of coming out, just gritting the water, allowing you to really effectively cover all the water. And certainly with this technique, it allows us to make sure that our flies are in the strike zone. Thus, you know, when we come through this water, we know we fished it pretty well. And if we fished a lane and didn't have a lot of action, we may make some subtle adjustments like fly weight, fly selection, tippet diameter, to improve our opportunity maybe on the next lane.